Dez, King of the Bit TV, we're listening to the 1975 self-titled. This one's entitled Talk. Let's go. Got almost like a polyrhythmic instrumental here. It's, I don't know where I should be bopping my head. Why do you talk so? Mistakes. Am I wrong in saying there's like an emo-esque vocal? Holding a melody, but there's this ever slight grit to it. There's this ever slight emotional value that ears it to, like, the emo bands of the 2000s, in my opinion. The popular ones. Or the emo adjacent acts, like your Panic at the Discos and stuff like that. Totally wrecked, blinking the way it talks, vocal cycle. I'm not talking about true emo. Don't get excited, people. Delayed, I'm chilling out the same. Why do you talk so?
About your mouth, a conversation superseded by the way it talks. A being anchored by my scheduled drone, it's safer on the ground. Why do you talk so loud? Why do you talk so? Why do you talk so?
Interesting stuff. I didn't think, I'm not saying it was bad, because it definitely wasn't, but it didn't speak to me, that tune. I appreciate it once again for the production value, for the outsider perspective they seem to have during the writing, because this isn't basic stuff. But this tune, it didn't really speak to me too much. Next we've got An Encounter, which might be an interlude between Talk and Heart Out. There's only one way to find out, people. Let's keep it.